guys, welcome back to day 4 of VBS. So far, we've been building on the foundation of God's love, forgiveness, worth, and today we're going to talk about promise. Which reminds me, I haven't seen Patrick. He promised he'd be here. Have you seen him?
Sorry, guys. Sorry, I'm running late. I was looking for today's scripture verse. It comes out of Matthew 28. It says this, "And remember, I'm with you always to the end of the age." Oh, wow. I'm glad God keeps his promises, unlike me. I'm sorry. I told you, I promised you I'd be here on time, and I didn't keep my promise.
It's okay, Patrick. In fact, I'm excited to see what is in the lesson today about God's promise.
I'm excited too. Why don't you guys go sing a little bit and then join us back here in the construction office in a few minutes. We'll see you in a little while.
Weeks pass quickly, and Renzo Wright has learned many things he thought he already knew. But Foreman Nehemiah and the Cobra Comb Construction Company continue to pull ahead. Things look hopeless for young Renzo. If he doesn't win, he will lose his reward. The use of the 34th floor.
Lloyd, I know sometimes I get mad, but you've always been like a brother to me.
Really?
That's why beating Cobra Comb has been so important to me. If we win, Mrs. Kuhlhaas said we could designate the 34th floor for a new kids' colossal Bible club, where kids all over the city could learn about God's love like we did. That's what my secret floor was for. But now I don't think it will happen.
Renzo, that's the nicest thing anyone's ever failed to do for me.
It's not over yet, Lloyd.
It's over, Renzo. Pack it up and go home.
I'm afraid he's right, Renzo. It's time to pack it in.
We can't give up yet, Mr. Santiago.
Yeah, think of the children.
It's not up to me. We've run out of girders.
Hey, genius! Check your math next time.
Mr. Santiago, that's impossible. I ordered extra, more than we needed.
Sorry, kid. It's true.
Oh, man. Things can't get any worse.
We're out of concrete, too.
Well, that's worse.
Looks like we put too much concrete and steel into the foundation.
What a waste!
It's okay to mess up, Renzo. I do it every day.
No, Lloyd. I did the right thing. There's no way I didn't order the right amount. I know it cost us a lot of time and materials, but to grow big, you have to build on a strong foundation.
You've come up short this time, Renzo. Literally.
Is this cool, Haas?
What's this I hear about running out of concrete and girders? Renzo, you said you would build the tallest building in the world, but you didn't even get the supply order right.
That's not actually...
Extra, extra, read all about it. Boy genius botches job, reevaluates his genius.
That paper boy is very dedicated to his job.
Mrs. Kulhas, there's been a mistake.
Yes, there was. Hiring you. I'm pulling your contract. You're no longer the chief architect. You're now assistant to the weekend intern. And don't expect to get your Bible club either.
Renzo, you lose!
Oh, God. I don't understand. I've never failed like this before. I did all the math. I was sure we had enough girders and concrete. I guess I really need your help. Truth is, I always have. It doesn't have to be the biggest building, Lord. Please, help us build the best building we can.
Even with all his smarts, the boy architect could not get everything right. But what's most important is that Renzo knew where to turn. Renzo remembered that Jesus had promised he will always love us, no matter what kind of trouble we get into. Jesus is our strongest foundation.
Hey kiddos, welcome back to day 4. Again, I'm Miss Haley. And do you remember what our most important tool that we need for life is? It is our Bibles. So make sure you have yours available. We're gonna be using that today. We're gonna be in the book of Matthew again in chapter 28. So you can get there on your tablets or your hard copies of your Bibles. And we also have another special tool that we are going to need today. And that is some nails. We've got a couple of big ones here. They're small ones. They come in all shapes and sizes. And I want you to listen for what they have to do with our story today, because it's really important. So go ahead and grab your Bibles, and we're going to be in Matthew 28. In Matthew 28, we're going to be looking at verses 1 through 10, and then we're going to skip a few and go to verses 16 through 20. Jesus was arrested for crimes that he did not commit. He was beaten, and he was nailed to a cross where he died for the sins of all people. His body was placed in a borrowed tomb. A large stone was placed over the opening of that tomb, and guards stood by so that no one could get in. The followers of Jesus believed their hope was gone. Early on Sunday morning, Mary Magdalene and Mary the mother of James walked to the tomb. There had been a violent earthquake, and an angel of the Lord had come down from heaven. The angel rolled back the stone that had been placed in front of the tomb, and he sat on it. The angel had the appearance of lightning, and his clothes were as white as snow. The guards who had been placed in front of the tomb to guard Jesus' body were so frightened, they fainted and they fell to the ground. When the women saw the angel, they too were frightened. But the angel reminded them that Jesus had risen just as he said he would. The angel invited the women to come see where Jesus had been, and then told them to go and tell Jesus' disciples, his followers, what they had seen. Jesus then met the women on their way and said, "Do not be afraid. Go and tell my disciples to leave for Galilee, and they will see me there." So the women didn't just walk, they ran to tell the disciples the great news that Jesus is alive. They told the disciples to go to Galilee, just as Jesus had told them, and that Jesus would meet them there. So the 11 disciples traveled to the mountain in Galilee where Jesus had directed them to go. And when the disciples saw Jesus, they worshiped him. Jesus said to the men, "Go and make disciples everywhere. Baptize people and teach them to do everything that I have told you." Then Jesus made an amazing promise. He promised to be with them always. So today's story is super important for us to understand. Jesus will always love you. And today's word of the day is one that we all need to remember and that brings great comfort. And that word is promise. So we're gonna add that to our crane today above the word worth that we've studied. Okay, if you have your activity books, I want you to get them out and turn to day 4. And it's on page 10 in the older kids activity book. So it gives you your story again, and then it has where your word of the day is, promise. And it says that Jesus taught us that we can trust God and believe his promises. And do you remember what his promise was in today's story? That he would never leave his disciples. He'll be with them, his followers, forever. And if you follow Jesus, that means he promises you the same thing. He'll be with you forever. You can also do this little activity called Concrete Promises. And you can look up the verses there and then write the promise that God gives us in each of those scriptures. And then I want you to remember, again, at the bottom where it says, nail it down, that Jesus will always love me. Hey guys, we've had a great day here, day 4 of VBS, as we've been learning all about God's promises. Now, if you stand up, we're going to go ahead and say our VBS verse before we close out our day. Are you ready? I am sure of this, that he who started a good work in you will carry it on to completion until the day of Christ Jesus. Philippians 1:6. I just love doing that verse with you guys. Now, make sure to grab your activity books. Preschool, if you'll grab your red activity book, today you're going to be on page 10 and 11. Make sure to get mom and dad's help to do your activity. Then, for first through fourth grade, like Miss Haley said, you're going to be on day 4, page 10. We love seeing you guys work through these books, so make sure you're taking pictures. Now, it's time to add our safety tag to our carabiner for today. So for preschool, find the green tag that says, "Jesus will always be with me." Don't you just love that promise? We're gonna add that to our carabiner for today. And then for first through fourth grade, your tag says promise. Jesus will always love me. What a great promise we have, knowing that God's love is for all of us forever. Now, make sure you put those back in your work bag so you know where to find them each day. Now, today's craft is a mirror that preschool through fourth grade, you all did the same one. At the top, it says, "Jesus will always love," and when you look in the mirror, you'll know he's talking about you. Jesus will always love you. Don't you just love the promises we're hearing in God's word? Well, I've had so much fun with you guys this week. We have one more day, if you can believe it, of VBS. So we'll see you guys right back here tomorrow. Have a good day.